new medical and diagnostic tools could put patients more in charge of their own care, eventually. As politicians debate how to improve the nation's expensive, and some would say broken, health care system, Americans are eagerly turning to the latest tech devices in hopes of preventing and detecting medical problems early and avoiding costly trips to the doctor or emergency room. Technology every day is playing a more important role in preventing and even diagnosing illness, said Gary Shapiro, chief executive of the Consumer Technology Association and author of Ninja Future, Secrets to Success in the New World of Innovation. We are just beginning this journey of revolutionizing healthcare and reducing trips to the doctor. Among the new inventions are many that use artificial intelligence, sensors or so-called Internet of Things, IoT, connectivity to a host of groundbreaking tasks, from detecting Alzheimer's from the sound of your voice to telling breast cancer patients, in real time, if their chemotherapy treatment is working. Some patients seek out new devices as if their lives depend on it. And for some, it does take Jeff Brew, a tech guru for Hollywood films. Mr. Brew was on his honeymoon in Mexico in 2016 when his spleen ruptured and he was rushed to a hospital in the town of Zihuatanejo for a splenectomy. Upon returning home to Los Angeles, doctors wrongly gave him a diagnosis of angiosarcoma, a rare form of cancer, and began an aggressive chemotherapy regimen to treat it. "They told me I had a year to live," Mr. Brew, who was then 34, said. Refusing to blindly accept the prognosis, he frantically searched the internet for data on his symptoms, which included a 105-degree temperature, and rushed the pathology reports to other major hospitals in the United States for additional opinions. A month later, doctors confirmed an error had been made and said he actually had non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, which was treatable. But by then, his immune system and liver had been damaged from the wrong chemotherapy treatments and from 7 biopsies. He's now awaiting a liver transplant in Pittsburgh. Mr. Brew attributes much of the misdiagnosis to outdated imaging tools and poor communication between radiologists and oncologists. "It's a systemic problem," he said. So between biopsies and positron emission tomography, or PET, scans, he set out to try and change the system. Mr. Brew took his OpenDrive's digital storage system, which had made him a tech rock star in the film and entertainment industry where he worked on productions like Gone Girl, House of Cards, and Deadpool, and brought it to the healthcare sector. His system will allow hospitals to store high-resolution MRI and CT scans, and other 3D images on its network without having to compress them. Most hospital networks compress stored images, which can make the images fuzzy and potentially cause doctors to miss information, said Chad Knowles, chief executive of OpenDrives. "And it's fast, a PET scan that might take 4 minutes to retrieve from a network, now takes 5 seconds," Mr. Brew said. "All of this makes it quick and easy to pull multiple high-resolution images, past and present, from the network, and share them with oncologists and radiologists in different offices," he said. He's also adding AI tools to help with diagnosis. The Stedman Clinic in Vail, Colo, a leading orthopedic surgical hospital, became the first health facility to bring in the OpenDrive system, and talks are underway with several others, according to Mr. Brew. Voice analysis technology, which can detect mental and physical health conditions, like coronary artery disease, Alzheimer's and even sleep apnea from the sound of someone's voice, is another promising area of advancement. The technology uses AI to assess hundreds of metrics, like pitch, tone, pauses, word choices, breathing and how a person describes a photo, to detect problems. The manner in which we speak and the word choices we make can be evaluated to accurately detect a growing list of clinical conditions, said Rich Ross, healthcare research director at Gartner, a research and advisory firm. Sonda Health, Winterlight Labs and Beyond Verbal are among the companies developing this technology. "We look at about 540 different metrics," said Liam Kaufman, chief executive and co-founder of Winterlight Labs, whose firm focuses on detecting cognitive medical conditions. "We published a number of studies in 2015 and 2016 that found we could predict Alzheimer's at the time with 82% accuracy, and today we're at about 93%," he said. Pharmaceutical companies, like Johnson & Johnson, Cortexyme and Elekta are using the Winterlight Labs voice technology for drug trials, according to Mr. Kaufman, but considerably more research and testing is needed before the technology is available to the masses. An increasing number of researchers are using AI to help radiologists make more accurate diagnostic decisions, especially in the area of breast cancer. About 41,000 women died from breast cancer in the United States in 2018, and women have a 1 in 8 chance of developing breast cancer in their lifetime, according to the American Cancer Society. Early detection is seen as key to survival. Regina Barzilay, a professor at MIT and a member of MIT's Computer Science and Artificial Intelligence Laboratory, and Constance Lehman, chief of breast imaging at the Department of Radiology at Massachusetts General Hospital in Boston, created an AI system to improve the detection and diagnosis of lesions seen on mammograms. Current diagnostic tools make it tough to know definitively whether a suspicious lesion is high risk, benign or malignant, especially if the patient has dense breast tissue, said Dr. Barzilay, who is a breast cancer survivor herself. She received the diagnosis and was treated in 2014. This can result in false positive results that lead to unnecessary biopsies and surgeries.